Hello dear students, so now we are going to start new chapter of your syllabus of biology, which is chapter 3. Till now we have discussed the first chapter and second chapter. In the first chapter we had appreciated the qualities of the living beings. What are their salient features? What are the characteristics which differentiate the living organisms from non-living organisms? We also had seen various ways, various tools which enable us to study these organisms of different types, of different kinds which are present on earth, be it animals or plants or whatever organisms, even it the microorganisms. ठीक है, तो we had studied the introduction of the diversity of the living world in the first chapter. Then in the second chapter we had seen the biological classification, where we had understood how the different kinds of diverse organisms which exist on earth, they are categorized, how they are placed together based on the certain common characteristics, how they are placed differently in different categories or groups which we call as taxa or taxon. And this all arrangement is based on similarities and dissimilarities of the characters. Initially, people were studying these organisms which are useful to us, but later on, people wanted to appreciate all the kinds of the organisms which are present on the earth and which may be of value for the human welfare. But later on, we started studying in more and more detail, right? So we had seen that different people had given different kinds of the ways to study the biological diversity. We already have seen that how a two kingdom classification was proposed initially, then binomial nomenclature system was proposed by Carolus Linnaeus. After that we had seen that R.H. Whitaker in 1969 had proposed a five kingdom classification system, and we have seen the details of these five kingdoms, which are Monera, Protista, Fungi, kingdom Plantae, and Animalia. So we already had seen different properties of the kingdom Monera and their subcategories. We also have seen that all the eukaryotic unicellular organisms are placed in Protista. We had seen that the kingdom Fungi consists of a very specialized group of saprophytic organisms which are having cell wall, which is not made up of cellulose, rather it is made up of a different material which is called as chitin. And these fungi are, again, they are not a true multicellular structure, rather they are filamentous structure, and they form a separate kingdom under the five kingdom classification. Then we had seen a very brief detail about the kingdom Plantae and Animalia in the last chapter. Now in this chapter, which is chapter 3, and it has been named as Plant Kingdom, here we will study in detail about the ways how the plants are studied to appreciate diverse kinds of the plants which exist on earth. Right? We already have seen a brief introduction about these plants in the previous chapter, which is chapter 2. So now in this chapter, we will basically focus on the plant kingdom. I already have told to you that plants include different kinds of categories, different kinds of the organisms, but essentially they all are photosynthetic, except few exceptions, right? So all the plants will be photoautotrophic, that means they will perform photosynthesis. They will have a cell wall which is made up of cellulose, and our plants will have obviously a eukaryotic organization. Eukaryotic cellular organization. Okay? So now we will study all these details and then we will see different kinds of the plants. As I have told you that there are different categories of the plants and there are algae, then there are bryophytes, then there are peridophytes. Okay, so algae, bryophytes, peridophytes, gymnosperms, and finally angiosperms. So in this chapter, we will study all of them in details. Okay, we will see what are different features of the algae, how they are different from the bryophytes, what are different categories or different kinds of the algae. So we will see different kinds of algae. What are red algae? What are brown algae? What are green algae? All those things we will study, how useful they are to us. Okay? Then we will see a very simple plants which are called bryophytes. They don't have any tissue level organization. They don't have a proper tissue level structure, but they have usually arranged cells which look like a plant. So they are the sort of very primitive plants and they are called as bryophytes. There are different categories of the bryophytes. We will study them. Then we will see the pteridophytes. Pteridophytes are the very primitive plants again, but they have the vascular system which enables the conduction of the water and mineral which is absorbed from the soil. Okay? Then we will study the gymnosperms and finally angiosperms. Now before going into all the details, we will see what are different kinds of the classification systems which were proposed by different people. Okay? And we will also see how the organisms which are present in the kingdom Plantae, all these categories currently, are not static if we see the history of the classification or history of the diversity of the plants. What does it mean? It means that earlier there were some organisms which were called as plants, but now they are no longer called as plants. There were some organisms which are now called as a member of the genus. For example, blue-green algae, they are photosynthetic organisms. Earlier they were placed in the kingdom Plantae. But in the five kingdom classification which was given by Whittaker, they were all placed in the Monera because they are prokaryotic in nature. So you don't have to get confused. You have to be very clear that all the prokaryotic organisms, whether they are photoautotrophic, whether they are autotrophic, whether they are chemoautotrophic, whether they are heterotrophic, all the prokaryotic organisms, that means all the organisms which don't have the nucleus. If you see, this is a cell and this is a nucleus inside the cell which has the chromosomes, right? This is a typical structure which you will be familiar. So if the cell has the nucleus, this is called as eukaryotic cell. If it doesn't have the nucleus, then it is a prokaryotic cell. So all the prokaryotic cells are placed in the kingdom Monera. And the blue-green algae are also called as cyanobacteria. So these cyanobacteria, they are placed in the kingdom Monera. Earlier they were members of the kingdom Plantae. Okay? Similarly, many of the members of the kingdom Protista, for example, unicellular algae, unicellular algae like Chlamydomonas, they are not now placed in the kingdom protista, because all the eukaryotic unicellular organisms are placed now in the kingdom protista. Earlier all the algae, that means all the organisms which are capable of doing photosynthesis, making their own food, they were placed under the kingdom plantae. And if they are having the cell wall, so basic characteristics, basic criteria for placing an organism into the kingdom plantae was the presence of the cell wall. If the cell is having this tough wall for protection, and if it is capable to do photosynthesis. This was the old system. But what happened? Later on, when Whittaker gave the five kingdom classification, various other criteria also were also given. And based on those, many of the members which were earlier in the kingdom plantae, they were taken out of the kingdom plantae and placed into kingdom Monera or kingdom Protista or even in the kingdom Fungi. So we have studied kingdom Fungi. You all know that kingdom Fungi have the organisms which are basically saprophytic. They are also eukaryotic organisms, right? So this saprophytic, but what they have a very conspicuous cell wall, but they are not photosynthetic. Earlier these fungi, because of the presence of the cell wall, they were included in the kingdom plantae. Now they are not included in the kingdom plantae. Now they are included into a separate kingdom, which is called as kingdom fungi. And let me tell you that this cell wall, which in the plants is made up of what material? This cell wall is made up of cellulose, right? In the kingdom fungi, this cell wall is made up of a material which is called as chitin. Okay? So let me tell you also that this cellulose is a polysaccharide. Chitin is also a polysaccharide. But these two are different kinds of polysaccharides. Fungi have the cell wall which is made up of chitin polysaccharide. Plants have cell wall which is primarily made up of polysaccharide of the cellulose. Okay, so in this way we have seen that the classification of the plant kingdom has never been a static classification. It has been a very dynamic one. Many organisms have been moved in and out. And according to our present understanding, where the five kingdom classification which was given by R.H. Whittaker is most accepted, there many of the old members of the kingdom plantae are included in the other three kingdoms, kingdoms Monera, Protista and Fungi. So which of the five organisms does not have the member of the old plantae kingdom? Animalia. So none of the kingdom plantae member has been sent to kingdom Animalia, right? So now, after having discussed this brief introduction, few other features about the classification. So this was about the history of the classification of the plant kingdom. Now, initially what happened, that people were doing classification based on a very few characters. Okay? And what are these few characters which were used by the people? These few characters were the very obvious, very common characters. For example, what is the habitat of the plant? Right? Habitat matlab kya hua? Plant kahan pe rehta hai? Kahan pe grow karta hai? Desert ka plant hai? या टाइगर टुंड्रा का प्लांट है, या फिर मिस्टर घाट का प्लांट है, या प्लेन्स पे रहता है, या हिली एरियाज में रहता है, राइट? या फिर वाटर के अंदर, यानी एक्वाटिक प्लांट है. तो दिस वाज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कंसिडरेशन फॉर असाइनिंग ए पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म इनटू डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज एंड ग्रुप्स ऑफ द प्लांट. सो हैबिटेट, देन द ग्रॉस एक्सटर्नल फीचर्स. If you see a particular plant, what are its obvious morphological features? Right? So these gross morphological features or gross morphology, these are the basic criteria for placing an organism similarly color. Okay, so in this video very few characters were considered, hardly the sexual characters were considered. Even if the characters were considered, there were many vegetative characters in nature. Okay, so vegetative characters were also considered, and they are obviously part of the grass morphology. But what are the details of the floral characters? उसके फ्लावर के अंदर कितने स्टैमन हैं, कितने कार्पेल या पिस्टिल हैं, कितने उसके अंदर पंखुड़िया हैं, जिसको कोरोला बोलते हैं, ठीक है, वो सब चीज फ्लावर के डिटेल्स को नहीं कंसिडर किया गया. व्हाट एल्स वाज इट, द यूजफुलनेस ऑफ दोज ऑर्गेनिजम्स वाज आल्सो कंसिडर्ड. ओके, सो दिस काइंड ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन which is the oldest system of the classification is called as artificial system of the classification. Okay, so now here you write the title, artificial system of classification. So under the artificial system of the classification, a few characters were considered, and these are the usually characters which were used. Carolus Linnaeus, who is very famous for what thing? Do any of you remember? Carolus Linnaeus, he gave binomial nomenclature. So Carolus Linnaeus used artificial system of the classification, and that is why this question is asked very often, because Carolus Linnaeus is very important. So he used artificial system of the classification. Now what was found, that if you use only few characters, there are so many disadvantages. Many times you place many unrelated organisms into the same taxa, into the same category together, and many closely related organisms may be placed far apart because you are considering very few characters only. Okay, so what happened, that is second system of the classification was proposed. What is that second system of the classification after the artificial system of the classification? Artificial ke baad kya aata hai, sabse behtareen cheez jo hoti hai natural system. So the second system is called the natural system of classification. So what happens in the natural system of classification? Under the natural system, natural affinities of the organisms were considered. Natural affinities among the organisms. राइट, नेचुरल एफिनिटीज का मतलब क्या हुआ, दो ऑर्गेनिजम्स अगर आप लेते हो तो वो एक दूसरे से कितना क्लोजली रिलेटेड हैं, सिर्फ उनका हैबिटेट सिमिलर है कि नहीं, इससे फर्क नहीं पड़ता. यू आल्सो हैव टू सी हाउ क्लोजली दे आर रिलेटेड बेस्ड ऑन सो मेनी अदर कैरेक्टर्स. सो इन द नेचुरल सिस्टम ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन, इंस्टेड ऑफ ए फ्यू कैरेक्टर्स, a whole range of several characters were considered. So large number of the characters were considered in the natural system of the classification. So now we will discuss more about the natural system of the classification in the next lecture, because this is the first lecture which I am making here in this lecture hall. And here I am trying to use the blackboard and this board and all this. So I am not sure how good is the quality. So let me stop over here. We will see interesting things about the planting in the next lecture. Okay. So thank you for watching. Be attentive and ask if you have any doubt, and keep noting all the important points. Take care. Bye bye.